In this video, we're going to be hiking and wild camping one of Scotland's best kept secrets, the East Highland Trail. Although a lesser known and much newer trail, in my opinion, it was just as good, if not better, than most of the Scottish trails have completed so far. This video is kindly sponsored by HelloFresh, delivering all the fresh ingredients you need to make deliciously simple meals from scratch. But more about that later in the video. Let's start the adventure. Hello and welcome back to Drunk on Wanderlust. Here we are, ready to hit yet another trail. We're doing loads this year, aren't we? This time it's a lesser known trail. It's called the East Highland Trail, not to be confused with the East Highland Way that I did last year. This one starts in Inverness, so here we are outside Inverness Station, and we're going all the way down to Blair Atholl. But I'll show you on the map. Let's have a quick look at the route, shall we? The East Highland Trail was devised in 2011 by Mark Carr. This 83-mile route starts in Inverness and travels down through the Cairngorms via the famous Lairig Ghru mountain pass to finish in Blair Atholl. The trail is not waymarked, but you can find the GPS map route on the Hiker app. I have been intrigued by this route since I discovered the map, so set off with some members of my Officially Smashed It hiking club to take on the challenge. Little did we know at this point it would end up being one of the best trails we had hiked so far.
Right, well, we've navigated our way out of Inverness and we're now at Wade Road, which will lead us to the outskirts of Inverness and into some wild country, which we're really looking forward to.
Okay, so like Steve said, we're coming down Wade Road and it looks like we're going to be on it for a little while. But we're on the outskirts now of Inverness, which is great because I don't like the residential walking. And the sun is out. Look how gorgeous it is. We are very, very blessed with the weather. I'm feeling good, pumped and motivated. So I think I'm going to run this section. Come on. Joining me on this East Highland Trail adventure, we've got Steve-O, we've got Tommy, and we've got David. Oh yeah. Okay, we're about 3 miles in, or 5 kilometres in, to the trail, and we've just come off a main path. We're now on a little track, and this is a steady incline. We've got about half of it still left to do, and we're heading towards our first water source, which is 6 miles in. Okay, so just bear that in mind. Coming out from Inverness, first water source is 6 miles into the trail. Let's have a look and see what we've got in store. Come on! I will try and include as much handy information about the trail as I can in this video for anyone else wanting to give it a go. I'm just having a look at your bag there, Tommy.
Oh, thank you very much, Kerry.
We weighed it at the train station and it's 21.5 kilograms. So we're interested to see what's in it later. We're going to have a good look and rummage through your sack, which is going to be lots of fun. But it is your first time doing a trail. So we live, we learn. And you're managing all right, so this is so good so far, isn't it?
It's all wonderful, Kerry. Thank you very much for all your help. You're an inspiration.
And I'm enjoying the hat. The hat is great. It's a nice touch.
You have all got hats on, so I thought...
Yeah, you've got to join the hat crew, haven't you?
Yeah.
Don't forget, if you would like to join me on one of my long distance hiking trails, you can find details of my free hiking club on my website, officiallysmashedit.com. We organise hikes in various locations that anyone can join in with, from day hikes to overnight trails. So check it out and get involved. Okay, we are at the top of the first hill. I say hill, the first climb of the day. We are still in the forest, which is beautiful. I've got a little bit of downhill now to get to the stream that I was saying at the 6 mile point. It's been stunning so far, really enjoying it. Yeah, let's have a look, see what we've got coming up. We were still following General Wade's military road that we had joined as we left Inverness, and we were heading towards Loch Moy, where we hoped to wild camp tonight. Okay, we're 6 miles in and we've just reached the River Nairn. Very beautiful down there. Now this was the place I thought we could fill up our bottles. It looks a little bit steep trying to get down from this side, so we're gonna head over the bridge and see if you can get down the other side, see if it's any easier. Come on. Turns out it was still a bit of a climb to get down. He's doing it. On the mission for water. Right, I'm going to show you where we are on the map. Not too far from that bridge that we've got water from. but we found a much more convenient water source. I'll show you exactly where we are and the measurements and everything. Look, nice and easy. So don't try filling up at that first one.
We had given ourselves a week to finish the trail, which ended up being the perfect amount of time. We could take it at a slow and steady pace and really soak up the beautiful Scottish scenery. Now, this was my first time back to Scotland since November, when I'd hiked the Three Locks Way, and I'd really missed it.
Just come out the other side of the woods. Scenery is opening up a bit. I'll spin it around so you can see. It is gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. Let's have a look.
So far, so good. I have to say, the majority of this trail was very easy to follow from the GPS map route. And if anyone is interested, I'll leave a link to it in the video description.
I'm having a snack stop. Snacks.
Snack.
My snack of choice today is actually a chocolate and cinnamon roll, which is very lovely indeed. I can't remember where I got it from, but I would recommend it to a friend. Eating my pack weight down. Probably brought only about 1.5 kilograms of food, but by the end of today, it should be a kilogram. Steve-O is having a snack.
Snack.
What are you having?
I'm having an almond and coconut nut bar deluxe.
Lovely. He likes nuts in his mouth, doesn't he? Way!
Come on, all of you.
Yay! Come on, Steve!
Here I come. I'm coming after you.
We are doing okay. We're about 2.5 miles away from the place that I think we'd like to camp this evening, which is quite exciting. Hopefully we're gonna get a lovely view of Loch Moy. We haven't seen it yet, but it will be coming into view pretty shortly. I can't wait to show you it on camera. And yeah, hopefully we'll get a really nice spot for the night, get pitched up, give you a little episode of tent life, tell you what's going on in my life, and cook some nice food. I'm excited.
It wasn't long before we reached the lock. We came off the main trail and took a smaller path down towards the water's edge to find the perfect camping spot.
Hello there everybody, this is Kerry and welcome to another episode of Tent Life. I'm here in my tent, which is my Big Agnes Copper Spare. Love it, absolutely beautiful. Now, what can I say about today? It has been a lovely day on the trail. What a nice start to the East Highland Trail. It's been really steady. We had a couple of slight inclines, two kind of big steady climbs, but it was so gradual, it really didn't take its toll. Scenery's been beautiful. Just really excited to be back up here in Scotland, and especially this part of Scotland, because I just really, really love it. I have got something very, very fun to show you. Two fun things to show you. First of all, my brand new camp shoes that are in the shape of lobsters. These are my lobster flops, which I'm going to put around the campground in, looking ever so cool. In the hostel in Inverness last night, I was wearing these. I was getting some really dodgy looks. But how cool are these? These are well cute. They only weigh 300 grams. And I was thinking, oh, shall I pack them? Shall I not? But I packed them. Now, my bag this time round actually weighed 15 kilograms, which to some people, they're probably sitting there thinking, I know you're probably sitting there thinking, oh, that's a bit heavy. But it was my choice to bring along some luxuries. And another luxury that I've brought this time is my brand new pillow. Trying to get it off, which is my flex tail pillow.
It's covered in down feathers from my sleeping bag. Sorry about that. But yeah, that's really cool. It's got a little handy elastic bit so it attaches to my sleeping pad so it doesn't like go off all everywhere in the night. And I found this really, really handy. Normally, I'll just sleep on my clothes bag to save some extra weight. But now I'm getting a bit stronger. I know that I can easily carry 15 grams and it's not, you know, it's not too heavy for me. So I can happily pack some little luxuries like this, which is nice. I'm just going to spin you round so you can see our view. Wait there. Du, 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 du. Oh my God, it's only a tummy, isn't it?
It's the Loch Moy Monster.
It's the Loch Moy Monster. We've spotted him. Look at that. Stunning, excited. And not a midge in sight at the minute. Touch wood. Whew. Right, good morning campers. Wow, what a night we had by the beautiful Loch Moy. I woke up to find a worm in my filter bottle, which was a little bit disturbing. I'll show you a clip. But I've just got to show you this. There is a worm inside my filter bottle. What the hell? I've been drinking out of this. I drank out of it and I'm all right so far, so fingers crossed I haven't got any that have slipped through the filter and into my system. Well, today's going to be beautiful. It was a little bit chilly in the night, but it stayed dry and it's staying dry today apparently. And we had zero midges. Can you believe? 27th of May, zero midges. We were very blessed. Thank you very much. Hopefully it will continue throughout the trail. That'd be really nice. It's nice and steady today. We're doing about 11-12 miles. I say that, I'll probably end up being about 13, knowing me. And it looks quite steady until the end. We've got a bit of a climb, but we're going to be fine. Looking forward to it. Come on, let's do it. What a beautiful spot we had picked. We had some brekkie and packed up our gear, excited and ready for the next leg of the trail.
Leave no trace.
We continued on the smaller path around the edge of the loch to meet up back with the main trail at Funtack Burn. The path then heads across some farmland en route to the River Findhorn. Taking a quick break by our Airbnb for the night. Just kidding. I've still got my little wormy hitchhiker. I tried to refill my bottle, shake him out, but he was stuck to the side and he just is not coming out. So I think he's just going to be there for the duration. He grew attached to me and he didn't want to leave. So yeah, I'm going to call him Wilfred the Worm and he will be our mascot for the trail. Well, funny thing just happened. I say funny, it wasn't funny, actually. It was bloody terrifying. We were in a field full of cows and they had baby cows with them. And a baby cow was trapped our side of the fence and all the big cows were the other side of the fence. We didn't realise that there was a gap in the fence. And as we were getting closer to it, the mum cow was looking like really shifty and coming down and she just kind of came through to our side to protect the calf and was looking at us like really dodgy and I absolutely shit myself, but luckily they did not kill us. We survived, but it was a heart-wrenching moment for me. My heart was pounding. It was very, very scary stuff. Oh, not dead yet though, not dead. Yes, we got our first glimpse of the River Findhorn and it was beautiful. I could see on the map we had to cross it very shortly and I was wondering how wet I was going to get attempting this. However, when we arrived, we discovered a bucket bridge. How bloody exciting! I'd never used one of these before. We're in the bucket over
over the river. We're about to pull ourselves across because the little winch is broken. So we're gonna We've stopped. Come on, Steve. Put your back into it. Pull, Steve. Pull, wee. Okay, I'm gonna put the camera down to give him a hand. Look at this. Not bad for a 76-year-old. Go on, Steve. So now I'm on my own this side of the river. Everybody else is over there, that side of the river. But I made it. I was really worried about that little bucket thing, but it was all right in the end. I was thinking, can it take both of our ways? But obviously I haven't put on that much. Put your back into it, come on. It's like gladiators.
Okay.
Come on, David, he's our man. If he can't do it, he's fucked.
Go, David, go!
We were all across, safe and sound. I was impressed by the guys. They'd done a fantastic job, despite me giving them some motivational banter. There's no hiding. There is no escape.
I'm happy. This is the beginning of a steep climb up 450 meters, sort of the high point of the day. We have a slight descent after that, followed by another climb of 150 meters or so, and then we descend down to our campsite for the night.
This trail has a total elevation of 2,837 meters, which is slightly more than the West Highland Way, although it's around 10 miles shorter in distance.
Okay, it is the end.
I'm going home.
We'll get a wheelbarrow.
First bus stop, I'm home.
We're a third of the way up the hill. Oh, pretty knackered. I think it's because it's at the end of the day. Do you know, if it's a climb at the beginning when you're feeling fresh, it's never so bad, but it's right towards the end of the day. It's the last bit and we're, it's taking it out of us a bit. Just going slow and steady. Luckily, we have got the most magnificent views to keep us distracted on the way up. So it's very, very pretty.
We kept climbing up and up, heading towards the bridge that crosses over the ford. And we'd seen there, the land looked quite flat and would be a great place to set up camp for the night. Hello, lovely people. It's time for another episode of Tent Life. As you can see, I am in the tent at the end of a day. It's probably about 5 o'clock now, so we've set up pretty early, which is good. We did about, I think Steve said we did about 12 miles today. What else can I say about this trail so far, apart from I'm really impressed. And I hope people are watching this thinking, do you know what? I really want to try that. We haven't seen another soul, apart from like a couple of locals yesterday that were walking a dog. We haven't seen a soul today, not a single other person. If you like kind of solitude on the trail, you like to have it to yourself and feel like you've got the wilderness to yourself, this is the one, and it's really pretty. I reckon we're going to have just more and more beautiful stuff coming up as the trail goes on. Oh, it's a nice little warm up anyway, because I've got the Bob Graham round coming up next month. I feel like I get back from one trail, unpack, and then I'm packing for the next one. This year's crazy. It's crazy. So much going on. Then I've got the Tour de Mont Blanc in July. And it's all a big build-up, all of them building up to the Cape Wrath that we're doing in September, me and Steve. And yes, that is the big one. And I'm thinking, I need to get my fitness up a little bit. I've had a little bit of a problem with my heart earlier on in the week. Well, I've got, I get ectopic beats, a bit of a regular heartbeat sometimes, and I had it quite bad earlier in the week, so I was a bit worried about this one, but I'm just taking it really steady, and so far so good. It's been okay, trying to keep myself nice and hydrated and not overdo it. Sorry, it's pretty windy today. I think they don't want the tripod to blow over. But yeah, I feel all right doing it. We're just taking it steady. It's Tommy's first ever hike, first time ever camping. And so he's just taking it steady anyway. He's struggling a little bit with the inclines because his bag is so heavy. But it was 21.5 kilograms. I think we've got it down by a few kilograms for him, just helping him eat his excessive amount of snacks. And I've taken his, he brought two of these big giant gases, so I've taken one off his hands just to make his pack a bit lighter, and I'll use it at some point, I'm sure, on the Cape Wrath. Yeah, so, and then the guys are doing all right. Yeah, that's about it for now. I'm about to have some tea, gonna have some foodies. I'm gonna have some pasta today. Had some cheesy mash yesterday, which was stunning, expertly cooked by myself. Today is cheesy pasta time, and some chocolate, I think, for after. So I'm gonna treat myself, why not? My tent is an absolute tip at the minute. I've just kind of chucked everything in because it was raining a little bit, hence the raincoat. It's stopped now, it's just nice and windy. But the weather is supposed to improve no end come Monday. It's meant to be glorious sunshine. Oh, please, please let it be glorious sunshine for the rest of the week. Imagine coming up to Scotland, having no midges and glorious sunshine. Still no midges, touch wood. Don't want to jinx myself though. Anyway, I'm going to go. I'm going to cook some tea. Catch you later. Bye. Tommy getting his flip-flops on. Oh, his feet have had enough of the day, but he did it. Bloody did it. Well done.
I only managed this with the help of you guys. I would still be sitting halfway up a hill somewhere dead. Not nearly dead.
You did well. You've done really well.
No. You guys,
you
are
still
amazing.
Look a bit sunburnt though.
Yeah, well.
I told you, I've got sun cream.
You don't get the sun in Scotland at all.
It's a rare treat. You wait till Monday, Tuesday when it's boiling.
Aye, I know, so help.
It's going to be nice. He is not going to be lost in that coat, is he? Look
That's
at that.
Right.
Like a shining beacon of hope in the distance.
One.
You are?
They asked me if I wanted the black one.
You said, hell no.
Hell no. I want to be found.
Yeah.
Dead or alive.
Dead or alive. Hopefully alive, you know. Let's be optimistic. Boom, I'm back. So this is what I'm eating. Ready-wise, creamy pasta and vegetables. And I'm going to put extra cheese in there. Probably some more pepperami because I brought like 1,000 of them. So that needs to go. And yeah, it's going to be really good. Yum, 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 yum. Dinner time. And whilst I cook up tea here, let's head home and have a look at this week's video sponsor. Hello, okay, it's time to have a look at another product. And this week, we're going to be cooking up a storm with HelloFresh. But I'm not going to be doing it on my own. Oh no, I've brought along a glamorous assistant. So please welcome out Dani!
Hi!
Now, you didn't think you'd be seeing her in this video, did you? Now, I brought her along actually because she is the world's worst cook.
Excuse me.
Well, you are.
I mean, I am. It's true. I burn toast. So.
And well, if you can do this, anyone can do this. If you haven't heard of HelloFresh, basically they provide all the fresh ingredients that you need to cook deliciously simple meals from scratch.
And hopefully they'll help turn me into a more confident cook.
We'll see.
So we had our box from HelloFresh delivered to our door yesterday, which was great because it meant I didn't have to go to the supermarket on the way home from work. And you get three meals, and Dizzy's ordered me a special vegetarian one as I don't eat meat. So let's see which one we're going to be cooking up today. So she's got me the honey lime glazed halloumi burger with peri-peri wedges and avocado salsa. That literally sounds amazing. That's like my favourite thing. I love the fact they do vegetarian options. And they're not boring vegetarian options either. They're really fun. And the menu actually changes weekly with 37 different recipes. And you can get lots of different cuisines and dietary preferences too.
I'm actually really enjoying learning new recipes as well, because I always just avoid cooking. I don't find it fun, but it's actually been quite nice to try something new and do it together, and for me to actually get involved. Usually I do the washing up, but you know, doing all the little prep and stuff, it's quite nice.
This is interesting actually. I've never put honey on halloumi before, so I'm interested to see how this tastes.
Wedges look pretty good. Danny's done an all right job of these, not bad. Put it all together.
Look what I did. It looks just like the picture, and I'm so excited to try it.
Okay, verdict time.
Apart from the fact that she's completely demolished the kitchen, she's done a good job of that. That was nice.
Thank you so much. I can't believe that I actually cooked that. I'm really proud of myself.
I can't believe you cooked that.
I know. And if I got that in a restaurant, I'm not being funny, but I'd be well happy. It's literally the nicest dinner I've had in weeks.
And the best thing, because neither of us actually drive, so to get to a supermarket, we've got to get on buses, or it's a very, very long walk. So it's actually really handy that they deliver and the exact portions of what you need. And plus, it's a lot cheaper than getting takeaway. And I enjoy cooking, and now that you can cook as well using this, I don't have to do it every night, which will mean it's more of a treat when you cook for me.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to use HelloFresh again. It was really, really easy, and I'm excited to try the 20-minute meals as well. Super quick.
So we have a really exciting opportunity for you guys. If you want to get involved in HelloFresh, go to the video description, click the link, and use our exclusive discount code today for 60% off your first box and 25% off the next 2 months. So that's 60% off the first one, 25% off for the next 2 months. I think that's a great offer.
Good morning, campers. Heidi hi, Heidi ho. It's time for another morning on the trail. This is day 3. On the East Highland Trail. We had some light showers this morning, hence I've still got my rain gear on because we're not sure what it's going to do. We've got some dark clouds looming, so you never know, so I'm just keeping prep for the worst. We're heading today about 11 miles down towards the town of Carbridge. I think our plan is to camp about a mile outside so we can head on in the morning. We've got a little bit of elevation in the morning, but all the afternoon is going to be downhill. Woo! So we're looking forward to that. Let's do it. Just in case anyone was wanting to stop in this little bothy thing, it's open and that's literally right next to the bridge we just camped at.
Chairs, tables.
Chairs, tables.
Wi-Fi. 52-inch TV.
All the luxury. But never mind, never mind.
Now you may have noticed there have been no resupply stops so far, no pubs or cafes since we left Inverness. The town of Carbridge is the first place you'll be able to resupply, which is 35 miles into the trail, so make sure you pack enough food and snacks. Just look at that view. Miles and miles of gorgeous wilderness ahead. This was definitely my kind of trail. A few miles on, we stumbled across another bothy, set back slightly from the path, so we had to investigate. This bothy had a plaque in memory of an aircraft pilot who had crashed and perished 200 metres from the bothy. It was quite an emotional read. The bothy didn't have any set sleeping areas, but there was plenty of space to hunker down on the floor, and it was set in some extremely beautiful landscape.
We've got three little ascents today. We're at the beginning of ascent number 2. Just working our way up nice and slowly. That bothy that we just passed, that was really cute. Doesn't come up on the hiker app, but I'm going to let them know it's there. We thought it was a hunting lodge, but after reading the little note on the wall, it definitely says it's a bothy, so good to know. Yeah, just taking it slow and steady, and I'll hit you back when we're at the top. Woohoo! It's time to start our last climb of the day, which is nice. It's a little bit longer than the last two. Shh, not telling the guys. But when it's done, it's done. Then it's downhill all the way from there. Nice one, Trevor! I said nice one, brother!
Just as we were taking a little breather, David found a pretty pink rock, which we later discovered was Himalayan rock salt.
So we smashed it into little lumps and we're all taking a little bit as a souvenir. Oh, how nice.
I only realised it was salt after I gave it a little lick. Don't ask me why I did that though, I'm not really into the habit of licking rocks.
Trotting through the mountains, having a bloody lovely time.
We pushed onwards to the top, and even though Tommy was really struggling with his giant pack, we all made it.
I am at the top, the highest point of today, which is just over 550 metres up, and the views are spectacular. I'll spin the camera around, you've got to see this.
Once again, we haven't seen a single living soul all day, but it wouldn't be long before we'd be leaving the moors and heading back towards civilization.
I think I can see another bothy from where I am, so we're going to go and investigate and let you know, because we're just trying to point out anything that might be of interest or informative on this trail in case any of you guys decide that you want to do it, which I think you should because it's been absolutely stunning. So let's go and have a look and see if this is a bothy. Well, the bothy is a bit of a graveyard, animal graveyard. Smells a bit horrendous, but obviously somebody at some point would move the dead sheep, I'm sure. I mean, if it was like a lightning storm, there's a roof if you needed it, and there is a toilet there, but at the minute there's a few too many dead animals in there for my liking. But there is a little bird's nest with some baby chickadees in there. I won't be going in there, I can't. The smell is just too horrendous from this poor one. Eek!
As we were leaving the moors, the sun started to come out, and then we had buildings in sight, and finally, we hit the road into town.
Hello and welcome back to another episode of Tent Life with Dizzy. Now, as you can see, I'm not actually in my tent for this one. There's a reason behind it. I don't want to leave my door open for too long because there's a few little bugs around tonight. I don't know if they're midges, but there's definitely some flies and stuff, so I don't want them all in the tent. As you can see, we're doing a lovely woodland camp this evening, and we're about a mile out of Carbridge. I'm not sure how to pronounce it. We've timed it nicely so we can nip in the morning and get ourselves a cooked breakfast, hopefully, fingers crossed. We found this little patch of woodland. It's actually not far off the road, so I can actually still hear cars, but we are far enough in to be still feel like kind of tucked away a little bit. It's very pleasant. We've got a nice little stream running just behind my tent. So we've got water. We've got I've got a moderately flat pitch. We're kind of scattered because we were just trying to find a bit of flat ground each, so we're not too far away. It looks like we've all fallen out and had arguments because Steve's over there, David's right over there, and Tomo's right the way down there. We're all tired anyway though tonight, so I think we're all gonna just cook some food, chill out and have an early night ready for tomorrow. We hit Aviemore tomorrow evening, very excited about this. Gonna get down that pub. I've got a pint of Guinness with my name on it. So I'll catch you tomorrow, guys. See you later. Night! Okay, good morning, everybody. We are now on day 4 of the trail. Sorry about the noise, we're just by a road. These were the woods that we stayed in last night. Had a bit of an uncomfortable sleep. It was freezing. It went down to 0 degrees. We were all a bit chilly. And then we had deers making all sorts of noises in the night. I thought it was cows, but apparently it's deers, like bellowing all through the night. Woke up this morning, I'm feeling really, really queasy. David's not very well either. Luckily, I'm all right at the minute. I haven't been sick or anything, but just feeling really queasy.
Hopefully I'll just walk it off. We've only got a mile to get into town. We're gonna have some scrambled eggs and I think I'll feel a little bit better. But yes, we're ready for this one. Staying in a hotel tonight in Aviemore. Whoop, 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 whoop. Let's do it, come on.
The sun was shining. We knew we all had soft beds and hot showers to look forward to tonight. So we sped into Carbridge to find a cafe for brekkie. There's also a spa here, so you can resupply if needed. Okay, we are finally off the road. Thank God. We've had quite a bit of road walking today. We had about a mile coming into Carbridge and probably about a mile leaving it as well. Don't like road walking, just throwing it out there. But now we're back on a little track and happy days, good. David's still not feeling too good. He had a tactical chunder outside the cafe, but then started feeling a little bit better. Hopefully that'll be his lot for the day. I'm feeling a bit queasy, but thank goodness, no sick so far. Just gonna crack on with it. Hopefully, I'm just walking it off. I'll feel better soon, hopefully. Let's have a little talk about Tommy, shall we? Tommy is from Scotland. Tommy's skin doesn't like the sun. Yesterday it was cloudy and cold. I had my coat on. Tommy got sunburnt. Very, very sunburnt. And today it's going to be a very tropical 19 degrees and he is dying. He's got factor 50 all over him, but I don't know if that's going to be enough. I think he might have to wear my poncho. The offer's there if you need it. It's just too warm though, isn't it?
It's scorching me. Arms are burnt, neck's burnt, back of legs are burnt. And if I was walking in the nude, my whatever's would be burnt.
He's like a walking pork scratching.
Oh, Scottish guys aren't made for this.
So Tommy had possible sunstroke and David had an upset stomach. Poor guys. Luckily, Steve was okay and I started to feel much better as the day went on. I think walking through this forest section helped. It always puts me in a good mood walking through woodland.
Grenade!
The temperature was rising and the weather forecast was looking fabulous for the rest of the week. We were almost halfway through the trail and I knew we had the prettier half coming up. So I was really excited for what was in store. Okay, a little bit of an update. So we are about 6 miles outside of Aviemore. As I mentioned earlier, David's been quite poorly, was poorly through the night. He's really not feeling too good. And Tommy is obviously like massively, massively sunburnt. They're both running short on water as well. So I think the plan is gonna be, they are gonna do a little detour to Boatofgarten, where they're gonna sit down, have a chill, have a drink, maybe catch the train or wait for a little bit and then join us afterwards. Me and Steve are just gonna hightail it into Aviemore, enjoy the beautiful weather, and we're all gonna meet up at Aviemore a little bit later. So we're excited to see what these next 6 miles have in store. Let's do it, it's beautiful, gorgeous sunshine. I am getting nice and bronzed. I've got my sun cream on though as well, always put your sun cream on. And yeah, let's do it.
Oh, the squirrels must be very fast around here.
We were really hoping we'd see a red squirrel on this section. Unfortunately, though, we didn't. Taking a little break in the woods. We've got 4 miles to go to get into Aviemore. That's Steve. He's just been for a wee in the woods. We know what you've been doing. We're in the woods. Still waiting to hear from the guys. We don't know whether they have caught a train or they're going to walk it after they take their little break. But as soon as they message, I'll be able to give you a little update. We're just currently walking through some gorgeous woods. Absolutely gorgeous. The sun is shining, getting a nice tan.
I'm looking forward to getting into town, to be honest, because looking forward to having a nice meal tonight, washing my hair, that's a big one, staying in a nice bed after the freezing cold night last night, just pampering myself a little bit. We're meeting up with Claire and Andy, who are joining us for the rest of the trail as well. Tomorrow's going to be a bit of a bitch of a day, to be honest. We've got a very, very large climb coming up to get up to the Bothy. I think we get up to nearly 900 metres, you know, so it's going to be a fun one, so stay tuned for that bit. Yeah, so we're going to crack on, do these last 4 miles, show you what this last section looks like heading into Aviemore.
The last few miles were really pretty and almost totally flat, so very easy going, which was a relief. We could just take our time and enjoy it. The closer we got to Aviemore, we could see the Cairngorm Mountains looming on the horizon, a glimpse of what was to come in the second half of this trail. We were getting hungry by now, so cranked up the speed for the last 2 miles.
So we're having a bit of a heat wave up here in Scotland. I think it goes up to about 20 degrees today, 22 tomorrow. We're discussing our choice of attire. Steve wants to ask the audience, how would he look in a tank top? Could he pull it off? I think he could. Tank top Steve, answers please in the comments.
Yes, I reckon he would rock a tank top. We could also knot a little white hanky for him to wear on his head. What do you think?
Dance for us! Woo! Give the people what they want, Steve. That's it. Oh yeah!
Just a quick reminder, if you've enjoyed this video so far, please give it a like. And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. I've got loads of different trails on my channel and loads more coming up this year.
There's a worm at the bottom of the garden, and his name is Wiggly Woo. Steve's new best mate.
Friend.
It looks like Wilfred that was in my filter bottle. He's determined to come with us, so we may as well just let him.
Hitching a ride.
He's very cute.
Weighs a ton.
I don't think it is a worm, you know. I think it's some sort of caterpillar. For your information, in case you were wondering, we've now joined up with the Speyside Way. You can probably see the marker there, one of Scotland's great trails. I did a bit of it on the East Highland Way when I did that one last year. Yeah, it'd be a nice one to do in its entirety. There you go, Speyside Way. Useless information. Constant verbal diarrhea from yours truly. Here all day.
Thank you all so much for watching the first half of this trail. Make sure you stay tuned for part two. Spoiler alert, it's bloody stunning. I've added a quick preview of what's in store, and don't forget to drop us a comment. We love hearing from you all.
Thank you so much for watching the first half of this trail, and another huge thank you to our sponsor HelloFresh. So don't forget, if you want that discount, click the link and use our exclusive discount code today for 60% off your first box and 25% off for the next 2 months.